Pioneer has performed standard UT and PT examinations of the Babbitt surface of this large hydroelectric guide bearing. An ultrasonic or UT examination reveals areas of broken bond between the Babbitt and the steel. The UT examination can be made based on ISO 4386-1 standard, DoD standard 2183, or a proprietary standard derived from these. Note that this bearing has dovetails, both on the joint faces, but even on the axial ends, which is far less common. Dovetails weaken the bond between the Babbitt and the steel. Dovetails also create difficulties for UT examination along these thickness transitions from thin Babbitt to thick Babbitt. Note that the regions where broken bonds have been detected are marked with red crosshatching. Regions of broken bonds are seen along the edges of the bearing. The criteria for acceptable UT results are more strict along the edges of the bearing, as broken bonds in these regions are expected to be more susceptible to growth over time during continued operation. Regions of broken bonds are also seen in the central regions of the Babbitt, away from the edges and away from the oil distribution grooving. A die penetrant testing, or PT examination, was made along the interface between the Babbitt and the steel on the axial edges and along the joint faces. PT examination can be made based on ISO 4386-3 standard or a related proprietary standard. In this case, with large regions of disbond, results of the PT testing are summarized as a percentage of the length of the PT indications compared with the total tested length. Pioneer relies on UT examination to determine whether the bond of a new or used bearing is acceptable. The bond of this bearing is clearly unacceptable. Pioneer recognizes that PT examination of used or refurbished bearings can display regions of false positives. False positive regions show PT indications, but the bond has good integrity. To provide a more sure evaluation, regions of PT indications should be retested with a more detailed UT examination. This uses a smaller diameter UT probe to allow testing closer to the edge. Note that in the presence of a large radius on the edge of the Babbitt, this retesting may not be feasible. Should the UT examination show areas of disbonding, then these should be marked. Where the detailed UT examination does not show evidence of disbonding, the PT indications are categorized as false positives. After years of service and possibly aggravated by the presence of all of the dovetails, the bond between this Babbitt and the steel shell is unacceptable. The next step for this bearing is recasting.